Hi and welcome to another episode of Mr. Puzzle. Today I will not show you the solution for these three puzzles, but only give you a small review of them. I will do a short unboxing, review each of these small puzzles, and after I solve them later I will give you some feedback about how difficult it was for me to solve them. So again, it's not a solution in this video, or I will not present a solution in this video, I will only review these three puzzles. All three are from Hanayama, one from the most difficult rating, 6 out of 6, and two with 5 out of 6. The first one is the helix, then the ring 2, and the square. So I will start with this unboxing of the square right now. So I don't need the boxes anymore. So actually I don't care if I will destroy them. And this puzzle is pretty heavy actually, most heavy of these three. And let's have a look how it looked like and how the mechanism works. So when looking at this puzzle, the first moment I think there's not much I can do. Ah, okay. When I pull them here apart, as you can see, the parts getting loose. Probably, so there's some twisting movement. And probably the parts will get loose and will fall apart, and I think it will be really a challenge to put them back together again. Interesting one, interesting move here. So let's see after I solved them how difficult it was. The next one is the Hanayama Helix. The Hanayama Helix here. Also interesting how Hanayama boxes their parts. Each one's in a separate box, yeah? Not, let's say, one for all design, but each puzzle has a separate box design and a separate way how to package them. Okay, so this is the helix. How does this work here? We have two rings that can be twisted like this. And also this ring here in the inside, which prevents the two rings or the two stars to be twisted too much actually. So what we I can imagine how what we need to do is we need to move this ring from one hole to another, and this will enable us to twist here these parts even more. And I think when looking on the box, yes, that we have only two parts here that can be separated, the star, the, let's say the two pieces star and the ring here. So it will be interesting to see on what point, probably somewhere here, I don't know. There are several areas where I might where it might be possible to remove the ring, but let's see here. I think it has, since it has 6 out of 6, it will be really a challenge to do it. Okay, and the last one is the Hanayama ring puzzle. Which is this one here. There's another ring puzzle already. Not sure if it is more difficult or easier than this one. But yeah. This one is 5 out of 6, so it should be already pretty difficult to do. See of how many parts it contains. after I removed all this packaging stuff here. So it will fall right apart, which is not good because I actually was not able to remember, or will not be able to remember, how the ring looked like in the beginning, maybe from this picture, but it will be difficult to, I think it will be difficult to get it back to the old shape. So we cannot separate the parts. This is the disassembly condition, which you actually, or not disassembly, but this is the, yeah, the, ah, let's say disassembled condition, and yeah, it's not really, as you saw, it's not really difficult to achieve this, but I think it's much more difficult now to get it back in the original state again. So these are the three puzzles, and I will start now to disassemble them and assemble them again, and in case I made it, I will give you a review at the end of this video, how difficult it was for me, and which one of these I prefer the most. Okay, so see you later. So in the meanwhile, I solved all of these puzzles, and I will go now from one to another based on my personal feeling about the difficulty. So as I mentioned in the beginning, this was 6 out of 6, 5 out of 6, 5 out of 6. We will start with this one here, this ring. Actually, it was a little bit disappointing because as you can see here, it just falls apart, so no skill required for the disassembly. And also I was able to assemble it, I think, within maybe 5 minutes. So this is a little bit disappointing. When I see a 5 out of 6 rating on the box, I expect it to be more difficult. Yeah, so not really one of my favorites. The second most difficult was this one, which has a very nice feeling when you touch it. Also, the solution is kind of nice, and actually I like these this kind of puzzles because they have this kind of mechanical design. I don't know, it's just nice and touchy, and the solution is also some nice idea. What's a little bit what's a pity with this one is that it can, if you handle it for sure, after some time it will, the parts will fall apart, and as soon as they fall apart, you will notice how this one works, and it will be easy for you to assemble again, and also the disassembly from that point will be easy. My personal rating for this one would not be a 5 out of 6, maybe a 4 out of 6. It took me, I think, maybe about 25 minutes to solve it, but I solved it, as mentioned, not because I recognized the trick. I just solved because the parts, due to my handling with the parts fall apart, and I saw the mechanics that's behind. So anyway, I think from the quality point of view and from the haptic point of view, it's a very nice puzzle. Unfortunately, it's a little bit easier than expected, so I would give it a 4 out of 6. And the most difficult here from the rating and also from my personal experience was this one. It has a 6 out of 6 from Hanayama, but from my point of view, let's say, it's more like a 5 out of 6 maximum. When you look at this puzzle in detail, you will be able to understand how it might work or how it could work, and it's just a matter of time until you solved it. Anyway, I like this one as well. My personal rating would be a 5 out of 6. Also, it's fun, and I think especially when you give this to unexperienced people who are unexperienced with this kind of puzzle, they will have a really hard time to solve this one. So I will also prepare a separate video for each of these puzzles, how to solve them in detail. And yeah, stay tuned for my next videos. I'm sure in one of the next videos I will present one of these puzzles and the solution in detail. Stay tuned.